Hi viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am here to explain about a poem, If I Was a Tree, written by Mudnakoodu Chinnaswamy. Chinnaswamy, one well-known Kannada poet, belongs to a place Mudnakoodu in Chamarajanagar, Karnataka state. This poem is written in Kannada, so we have a translator, Rowena Hill, who has translated this poem into English. I'm here to explain about this is Chinnaswamy. He is a contemporary poet and he has given us a very important, very practically applicable, very
in the poem topic.
The very first line is the title, If I Was a Tree. So Mudnakoodu Chinnaswamy has taken this as a title, If I Was a Tree. Remember, as I said earlier, the racial discrimination and untouchability, this is the main social concern, the problem poet has taken. The poet has taken this and he is finding a solution. Not only is giving the problem, he wants to give us a showcase, his solution. What is that? So, if I was a tree. So, directly, very first line only, he starts with the solution. Why he wants to become a tree as a part of the solution. So, if I was a tree, the bird wouldn't ask me. See, bird, part of the nature. Bird wouldn't ask me before it built its nest. So, bird building nest, it is a natural process and bird never asks any tree. Which caste you belong to? Moving further, what caste I am? So I becomes the tree. So the poet is making an assumption that if I was a tree, why he intend to become the tree? Because the society has treated him like untouchable. So he wants to forget this society. He wants to move away from the society. The birds will build its nest on a tree. Then, when sunlight embraced me, me means as a tree. We need to, as a reader, as a student of literature, we have to understand that the poet has become a tree now. And as the tree, sunlight embraced me, my shadow wouldn't feel defiled. Defiled, very important. Considering impure, the society treating like untouchable. So in the nature, you never find, the poet is telling that in nature, equality is there. So nature considers everybody as equal. So the sunlight, the bird, okay, they consider equal all the trees. My friendship with the cool breeze. So once again, these are the elements, bird, sunlight, cool breeze, and the leaves would be sweet. So when I am the tree, when I have become the tree, why I was a tree, I will be very happy in nature because no part in the nature will consider me as untouchable, defiled. So the poet will not have any regret. So he feels very happy. He involves himself and he wants to become a tree. So the reason also he is explaining. Like the sunlight, leaves, cool breeze. Similarly, raindrops wouldn't turn back, taking me for a dog eater. Me means the poet becoming the tree now. Dog eater considering him as untouchable. When I branch out further from my roots, when I, once again the poet, now he has become the tree. So branch out, you know, when the tree spreads its wings, branches out further from my roots, Mother Earth wouldn't feel
I branch out.
See, now the poet is no more the poet. He has become the tree. So as a tree, when he spreads his roots, branches, Mother Earth wouldn't flee, considering him as untouchable, racial discrimination. So what the poet is trying to tell here, sun rays, cool breeze, bird building the nest, leaves, even the raindrops. So all these are the elements of nature which considers the poet as a tree, one among them. So they never consider as a racial discrimination. So equality is there. So the poet started with if I was a tree and he is finding the solution. So why he intends to become the tree? Because in nature, equality is there. Whereas in the society, we cannot find any equality. Only in nature, which is divine, equality is there and there is no racial discrimination. Untouchable feeling is not there. So the poet feels as a tree being accommodated, being taken inside by the nature. That is a very important message the poet is trying to tell. As a reader, student of literature, we need to concentrate on that. That is one of the very important. It is almost like a solution for the racial discrimination and untouchability in this world, in this society. Next part of the poem where Mudnakoodu Chinnaswamy is taking a different term and he is trying to tell us further. So as a tree, remember, the poet has become a tree now. As a tree living, what are the aspects, elements of nature considering the tree as an insider? They never consider the tree as untouchable. Further, if in all these instances also, if he is not becoming pure, impurity remains, further the poet comes out with a thought, the sacred cow would scrape her body on my bark. Sacred cow. See the Kamadhenu, the concept of Kamadhenu, sacred cow, which is holy, divine. So sometimes cow may come and scratch its body, scratching wherever it itched, and the 3000 gods sheltering inside her would touch me. So what is a very interesting part here? Cow, sacred cow, you know, in the Hindu mythology we consider it cow as a holy, divine. And even in the housewarming ceremonies we always first bring the cow, sacred cow, inside the house as a part of divinity, and we always respect cow also. So now what the poet is trying to tell, in case if he becomes the tree, why he intend to become the tree? To make himself pure from all the impurities in the social structure. So in nature, cow is considered a divine force, and by its touch he will become pure, all the impurities will be disappearing. That is the intention behind the poet. If I was a tree, behind poet becoming the tree is he likes to come out of the social discrimination, because the society always treats people belonging to the lower strata, low caste people, assuming himself as the tree is that only. And the cow, holy cow, after touching it will make the final stage where, who knows, at the end hacked into pieces of dry wood. So when the tree was living, that is the part. Now when the tree is dead, so it will be cut into pieces of dry wood, burning in the holy fire. The poet, after becoming the tree, after its death, the tree can be used for carrying the dead body, a sinless body, or borne on the shoulders of the four good men, and with that he can reach the almighty, or he can be
said earlier.
This being the Kannada poem written by Mudnukudu Chinnaswamy, it has been translated from Kannada by. To conclude, finally, in this picture you can find the main theme of the entire poem, If I Was a Tree. The poet having the concept of assuming himself as a tree, almost like the Kalparaksha concept, and the holy cow, that is the Kamadhenu. So the Kamadhenu and Kalparaksha, the poet intends to find a solution to this social discrimination. He wants to reach the divine, make himself pure by all the impurities in the society. It is almost like man is ball free, but everywhere he is in chains. This is a famous statement by Rousseau. I think that is what this theme is all about. Mudnukudu Chinnaswamy tries to imply the same theme in his poem also. So that is the solution of the poet. Never blames here anybody. He knows the system. He also know, he tries to, as an individual, as a poet, creatively, you know, he is assuming things, and he, as a tree, you know, tree symbolizing the nature. So in nature there is no discrimination. Why in the society? So as the poet is trying to find a solution, the educated people, we need to find solutions to all this social discrimination, and we need to move away from that racial discrimination, untouchability and all. So the poet has come out, you know, he is not blaming any system here. He is thinking that in the nature we don't find any type of discrimination. Sunlight, raindrops, cool breeze, bird building nest, the mother earth considering everybody equal. So in nature there is no discrimination. What about the human world? Only, so it is, the entire story is about predominantly nature versus human world. Only in human beings, in the society, we find social discrimination. Why this disparity? So Mudnukudu Chinnaswamy, finally, he comes up with a solution. What is that? We as the educated people, we need to look at the nature and find solutions, and nature will tell us all the solutions. And finally, we have to move away from all this social discrimination, racial discrimination and untouchability, all this, and we need to go and take the society into better. And thank you for watching my YouTube channel. Please like and subscribe.